Welcome to my channel. My name is Attila and this is Masterpiece. Today I am going to make something silly, something funny, maybe a little bit cartoonish, and definitely something that doesn't make any sense whatsoever. I designed something and I call this one the silly vase. So basically we are going to make something where the proportions are not right and it doesn't make any sense. That's how I can explain. Okay, so let's go downstairs and I am going to show you what's going on, even though I am not entirely sure what's going on, but hopefully we will end up with something funny.
Mustard piece.
If you're new here, well, this is my shop. Not much, but it is more than enough. Let's get to it. I have found this one because I bought it. That's why I found it, because I put it there. Anyway, so I'm going to use this ball blank. This is brown ash. And we are looking for some kind of cartoonish, over-exaggerated forms. The opening will look like a trumpet, long neck trumpet, and we will put multiple openings on it, all of them like a small trumpet, and hopefully that will look fancy, cool, and maybe a little bit silly. Let's get to it. I can't drill holes here, because that will be the top. Hot glue. Not the safest option though. Oh, by the way guys, this year I definitely going to compete in the Wizardry in Wood Woodturning competition. 100% I will be there. 100% I am going to enter with at least one piece, maybe more. And I know I announced it last year and I didn't compete. Not because I am a liar, but because the competition has been cancelled because of the COVID-19. So I didn't have a chance to show what I'm made of. Hopefully this year in October I will be there, 100%. Okay, so let's continue with this study of a shape experiment that we started 2 videos back. And what I am trying to do here is a perfectly symmetrical shape. And I want you to look at the shape, and one side is slightly thicker than the other one. And I want you to tell me which side I should take some off to get a perfectly symmetrical shape. And it's not easy. Some of you will be able to do it because you have the practice, but some of you may be just starting and you have to train your eyes to be able to recognize slight differences. If you can do it, well done, but if you're not, it's probably drawing a shape. It's your best bet to practice that, because when I draw, I just slightly modify the curve and then I get a perfectly symmetrical. So drawing is really good for wood turning. Anyway, tell me which side I should take some off. So basically here is the middle and this is the nice side. and it is identical these two sides until this point. So this is perfectly identical, so I only have to take some away from here and then I hopefully will get a perfectly symmetrical shape here. If I want to, obviously, if I don't want to, I don't have to. So now the next step would be to make a mounting point on the bottom. And I know from experience, the only reason this thing is still attached to my lathe and not flying around, because I only used hot glue if you remember, it is because the center is on. Let me show you how secure hot glue is. Just keep it in mind when you attach something with hot glue, that's how secure it is. Yeah, so don't trust in the hot glue. Okay, so let's start to hollow it out. I won't be able to photograph anything inside. Literally, I am going to put together a half a minute montage. I'm not going to waste time on this one. Let's do this. So, it's about this deep. It's fairly good. It's definitely good enough. Okay, so now the fun is going to start. I am going to make the mouth or the trumpet of the vase, and I am going to use this wood. Don't even know how to pronounce it. Opepe. I'm going to glue these two together so it becomes a little bit longer. Okay, let's hollow it out. Thank you. So basically it's pretty much done. The next step would be sanding. And I know sanding is boring and nobody likes it. So let me show you the most effective way of sanding and just pay attention because this stuff is really important. So the first, the legs. The legs must be like this. Just play it cool. So next step, elbow. Elbow must be on the left, like this. But the most important thing is the face. It's like, I'm sending. I'm cool. Can show you it in action. All these years, huh? Come on, hit that like button. Okay, look at this. It's like a horn. Dee dee dee. It's pretty cool. So, look. Goes in like this. Obviously, I am going to fix this part. And I just realized that's not going to be easy. Probably have to use micro tools for this. Oh. So now I am going to make three of these identical off camera. Actually, these are exactly the same as the large one. The only difference between them and the large one is that I keep breaking them. Watch this. I love it when a plan comes together. So I messed this one up. I also messed this one up. That means 3 hours of work for absolutely nothing. Look at this band I made. Show you how to do this. It's fairly simple. So literally the only thing you have to do is just cut it in an angle, twist it, glue it back together, and sand off any excess. I show you. So this is the part when you twist it. I made epoxy.
Mustard piece.
You can also use it as a very strange social drinking cup. One from here, other ones from here. Just saying.